Hello and welcome to The Indescribable God and to another episode on Understanding the Great I Am. I have read this passage before, I think at least twice in my life I have read this passage, but both the times I never understood this passage. The reason my attention was drawn to this passage was because one day on Facebook I saw a post: Samson took the city gates of Gaza and therefore the Philistines took his hair. And the person who sent out the post said, "As you sow, so shall you reap." And when I read that, I was not convinced that what was connected of sowing and reaping was right in that circumstance, in that situation of Samson, you know. So I pulled out the Bible and I asked the Lord, "Lord, you explain to me about Samson." Because when I read it, I was like, "Lord, he did take the gates and he took it. There is no reason for him to take the gates." And then the Lord made me reread this passage, and I'm going to read it for you and explain to you what God told me. "Now Samson went to Gaza and saw a harlot there and went into her. When the Gazites were told, 'Samson has come here,' they surrounded the place and lay in wait for him all night at the gate of the city. And they were quiet all night, saying, 'In the morning, when it is daylight, we will kill him.' And Samson lay low till midnight." This is verse 3. "And Samson lay low till midnight, and then he arose at midnight, took hold of the doors of the gates of the city, and the two gateposts, pulled them up, bar and all, put them on his shoulders, and carried them to the top of the hill that faces Hebron." He went to the harlot. Those people were waiting for him outside the house, and then he takes the city gates. And then the Lord made me reread it again. And he made me focus on verse 2, which says that they lay in wait for him all night. And the important key point is at the gate of the city. You see, these people waited at the gate of the city for Samson, and they planned to ambush him at the gate of the city. So Samson had no idea about this. Because when they went and they spoke to the others in the city, they made a plan, but the plan was not made in Samson's presence. Samson was busy at that time, so he had no clue about this plan being made against him. Now they thought that he will get up in the wee hours of the morning and he will go home, and that's the time that they will attack him. But Samson, for some reason, okay, he got up at midnight and he decided, "Okay, I'm going to go home now at midnight." And when he went, that's when he saw these people at the gate of the city. And then he realized that they are waiting in ambush for him. Now, these people, because they were expecting him to come in the wee hours of the morning, you know, were not ready for him. So they probably were asleep. By midnight, they probably were fast asleep. So when Samson saw that they are waiting for him over there with all the, you know, arms and weapons and all, he decided to take out the gates of the city and go away from there, taking the city gates. Now you'll wonder why. Why would you take the city gates? Logically speaking, if they're waiting in ambush for him, it's better to just have a war with them and finish them. Have a fight with them and finish them, because after all, he has the anointing, right, of God. And whenever anybody comes to attack him or attack the people of Israel, the power of God would come on him and he could destroy all his enemies every time. So why waste his time pulling out the gates and not touching the people of Gaza at all? The second thing is that if he was pulling out the gates, definitely, since he's pulling it out from its very foundation, it's bound to make some noise that should wake the people of Gaza up. But apparently they did not get up. They didn't wake up. I asked the Lord, that, "Lord, why would he do it this way? Why wouldn't he just attack them and finish them off?" And then the Lord made me realize it's because Samson was not being directed by his own mind, but he was being directed by the mind of God. And God never fights a battle like we humans do. He always, always fights a battle in such a way that the enemy is always left not just defeated, but dumbfounded. And that is the beauty about our God. You see, when Samson took the gates, in other words, what he was saying is, "I've defeated you and left you wide open for any enemy to come and attack your whole city, for any beast of the land to come and attack your whole city. It was not, the gates by themselves have no value, but the city gates are put there to protect the city. It's a very important part of the city. So if you take away the city gates, the doors are wide open, and if the doors are wide open, anybody can come in, anything can come in. And that is what Samson was saying, that you wanted to kill me and destroy me, but my God has defeated you and left you open to all your enemies, not just me. And he took the gates and then he walked off, proving that they were defeated. Now, the second thing, the reason that they did not wake up with the sounds of the gate as it kept moving and coming out of its foundation was because God's power is so great that God put them into this deep sleep that they never heard the sound. The people, or the Philistine people, did not take Samson's hair because he took the gates of Gaza. He took the gates of Gaza because they tried to kill him, because they planned to kill him, because they planned to do evil for him, and as a sign of their defeat, he took the gates of Gaza. So that was one thing I wanted to clarify in the sharing, you know, to many people who may have seen that post. Well, brothers and sisters, that will be all for today, and I will see you soon in my next episode of Understanding the Great I Am on my channel, The Indescribable God. I look forward to seeing you again. Till then, have a wonderful day, and God bless you abundantly.